Hi, I welcome you all in this course, Power Electronics. In my opinion, it is the most important subject of electrical engineering. The subject is very interesting and very easy to understand. Its prerequisites are basic electrical engineering, basic electronics, circuit theory, digital and analog circuits, control system, and power electronics is prerequisite of subjects electrical drives and industrial electronics. That's why this subject is generally taught in 5th or 6th semester. So this subject is very important. Course number UEE504. Credit awarded to this course is 4.5 and number of lectures to be taken approximately 50, and simulation tool for explaining the circuits and the waveforms I will use PSIM and MATLAB. This subject, power electronics, has already advanced to the point that it is difficult to cover entire subject in 50 to 60 lecture classes or in one semester. Based on that, here only introductory level power electronics we will discuss, and accordingly the syllabus is developed. Module 1, introduction to thyristors and its family, we will discuss. Then static and dynamic characteristics, turn on turn off methods, firing circuits, ratings, protections, and series and parallel operation of thyristors we will discuss. More about this we will discuss in lecture class. Thyristors are just like transistors, three terminal device, but the difference is thyristors has higher voltage blocking capability. It is the only semiconductor based switch which is suitable for high power applications. In module 2, phase controlled converters. Principle of phase controlled converters, single phase converter circuits, three phase converter circuits with different type of loads like R load, RL load, RLC load, RLE load, then different conduction modes of these converters, continuous and discontinuous conduction modes, effect of source inductance, dual converters and their operations. In brief, I will discuss in module 2. Phase control converters are nothing but control rectifiers. These are used for AC to DC conversion. Module 3, DC choppers. Principle of chopper operation, control strategies, types of choppers, step up, step down choppers, steady state time domain analysis with RLC load, voltage, current, and load commutated choppers. So these things we will discuss in module 3. Choppers are used to convert fixed DC voltage to variable DC voltage. Inverters. Inverters are used to convert DC to AC. In this module 4, we will discuss single phase voltage source bridge inverter and their steady state analysis, modified McMurray half bridge inverter, series inverters, three phase half bridge inverters with 180 degree and 120 degree conduction modes, single phase pulse width modulated inverters, current source inverters with R load. Qualitative approach here I will cover. Module 5, AC voltage controllers. Here the controllers are used to convert fixed AC voltage to variable AC voltage. In this module, we will discuss types of single phase voltage controllers, single phase voltage controllers with R and RL type of loads. Module 6, cyclo-converters. As the name cyclo-converters, it indicates that it will convert AC signal at one frequency to output signal at variable frequency. It can also change the output voltage level. In this module, we will discuss principles of operation, single phase to single phase step up and step down cyclo converters, three phase to single phase cyclo converters, output voltage equations for the cyclo converter. A step up cyclo converter means if the input voltage is at one frequency and output voltage we are getting at increased frequency, then that is a step up cyclo converter. And if the output frequency is less than the input frequency, then that becomes step down cyclo converters. Now from three phase also we can extract single phase output at different frequency. After the completion of this course, it is expected that you will be able to select the power devices as per the uses for energy conversion and control, exhibit the designing of firing and commutation circuits for different converter configurations, analyze various converter configuration topology with different types of load, identify converter configurations for various power applications, exhibit the uses of power converters for harmonic mitigation, voltage and frequency control. These are different textbooks and reference books for this subject. MHRC Power Electronics. Nedmohan, Power Electronics Converter Applications and Design. B.K. Bose, Handbook of Power Electronics. G.K. Dubey, Thyristorized Power Controllers. And P.S. Bimra, Power Electronics Khanna Publishers. Here we have seen specific information about the course. From next class, I will start Module 1, Introduction to Thyristors and its Family. Thank you.